controversies. And he said to them, the Sabbath was made for men, and not men for the Sabbath. Therefore, the Son of Man is also Lord of the Sabbath. Yeshua's behavior is his way of preaching, and even his healings came into direct conflict with the traditions of the religious authorities. They considered him blasphemous, glutton, and friend of sinners, Sabbath transgressor. They even accused him of working for Beelzebub. His own relatives came to believe that Yeshua had lost his mind due to overwork. Without a doubt, the life of Yeshua was a controversial life. Controversy over forgiveness. Food controversy. Controversy over the Sabbath. Controversial questions about Yeshua. With what power does he work miracles? Is Yeshua crazy? Controversy over forgiveness. When Yeshua saw their faith, he said to the paralyzed man, "Son, your sins are forgiven." When Yeshua returned to Peter's house in Capernaum, many people came to listen to him. Four friends approached so that Yeshua could heal their paralyzed friend, but they could not get close to him. Determined to bring him to Yeshua, they went up to the roof and made an opening to lower him down. Yeshua's speech was interrupted, and everyone remained silent, waiting to see what Yeshua would do. "Your sins are forgiven you," the paralytic could have claimed. "What I need is to walk," but he didn't do it. Yeshua healed the root of his illness. He didn't care about not walking again, but about the forgiveness that gave peace to his soul. To the scribes, this was blasphemy. True, if Jesus, Yeshua, were not Elohim. To demonstrate that he had the power to forgive, Yeshua healed the paralytic. The people praised Elohim for giving Yeshua the power to forgive sins. The paralytic walked, but the scribes were left blind, unable to see that Yeshua could read their minds, forgive the sinner, and grant him healing. Food controversy. As he walked along, he saw Levi, son of Alphaeus, sitting at the tax collector's booth. "Follow me," Yeshua told him, and Levi got up and followed him. It's not difficult to imagine the controversy that Levi's call aroused for an Orthodox Jew. A publican was worse than a Gentile. He was a renegade Jew, sold to his enemies. They couldn't eat with him or touch him. But things got worse. Yeshua not only ate in a tax collector's house, he surrounded himself with many like him. The critics did not waste the opportunity. What is this that he eats and drinks with publicans and sinners? Yeshua refuted them logically. "Where better than here will I find sinners to save?" Additionally, he challenged them to examine their own feelings. They had to learn to love. Food controversy. Yeshua said to them, "Can those who are at the wedding fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom with them, they cannot fast." Far from learning to love, the Pharisees incited John's disciples to join their criticism. How is it that John's disciples and the disciples of the Pharisees are fasting, but yours are not? Yeshua's response came in the form of parables. The parable of the wedding. How can someone fast while at a wedding? The bridegroom is Yeshua, the guests, the disciples. When Yeshua died and was resurrected, then his disciples will need to fast. The parable of the new and the old. The living teachings of Yeshua had no place in the dead teachings of tradition, and vice versa. Controversy over the Sabbath. The Pharisees said to him, "Look, why are they doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" The Pharisees taught 39 forms of work that transgressed the Sabbath rest ordained by God. By taking the grain and removing its husk to eat, the disciples performed 3 forbidden works on the Sabbath: harvesting, threshing, and winnowing. Yeshua responds, "Don't you remember that David, when he was hungry, ate the consecrated bread, which only the priest could eat?" Later, Yeshua performed a work not included among the 39, but it was also considered a transgression of the Sabbath: healing. Yeshua responds, "Which is lawful on the Sabbath, to do good or to do evil, to save life or to kill?" Ultimately, Yeshua is Lord of the Sabbath, and He gave it for us for good. Curiously, the zealous Sabbath keepers plotted a murder. Controversial questions about Yeshua. But with what power does He work miracles? And the teachers of the law who came down from Jerusalem said, "He is possessed by Beelzebul, by the prince of demons. He is driving out demons." Mark begins a story about Yeshua's family, but interrupts it to narrate a controversy with the Pharisees. Later, he will return to the first story. This pattern is used by Marcos on several occasions to join 2 similar stories, highlighting the central one as the most important. Mark 3:20-21. Yeshua's family is looking for him. Mark 3:22-30. Pharisees. Mark 3:31-35. Yeshua's family is looking for him. In this case, the important story is the scribe's accusation as to what power it was that allowed Yeshua to cast out demons. Again, Yeshua uses parable to demonstrate the absurdity of the accusations against him. Yeshua enters the house of the strong man, Satan, binds him, and thus can plunder his property, free the demon possessed. It also takes the opportunity to warn of the danger of attributing the work of the Holy Spirit to the devil. Is Jesus crazy? When his family heard about this, they went to take charge of him, for they said, "He is out of his mind." What made Yeshua's family think that he had gone crazy? Overwork, poor nutrition, stress due to his continuous discussions with scribes and Pharisees. After a brief parenthesis, Mark resumes the story, introducing relatives who were looking for Yeshua, his mother, and his brothers. What a lack of consideration for his family on the part of Yeshua. But appearances are deceiving. His mother and brothers were wrong. Leaving his work to attend to them at that moment was detrimental to his mission and to themselves. More important than carnal ties are these ties that unite Yeshua with his spiritual family. Whoever does God's will is my brother and sister and mother. The spirit of persecution will not be excited against those who have no connection with God and who have no moral strength. It will be aroused against the faithful ones who make no concessions to the world and will not be swayed by its opinions, its favor, or its opposition. A religion that bears a living testimony in favor of holiness and that rebukes pride. that tears a living testimony and that rebukes pride, selfishness, avarice, and fashionable sins will be hated by the world and by superficial Christians. When you suffer reproach and persecution, you are in excellent company, for Yeshua endured it all and much more. If you are faithful sentinels for Elohim, these things are a compliment to you. It is the heroic souls who will be true if they stand alone, who will win the imperishable crown.